नाला वारा वो खुश आमदीद खम्मा घणी माई डियर लर्नर यू मस्ट बी वॉन्डरिंग वट एम आई डूइंग आई एम डूइंग नथिंग बट वेलकमिंग यू इन येट अनदर वीडियो लेसन ऑफ कोर्स कोड 503 लर्निंग ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस एट एलिमेंट्री लेवल ऑफ डीएलएड प्रोग्राम NIOS. My dear learner, you must be knowing that India is a country which is known for its diversity. And what I have exhibited in front of you right now is its linguistic diversity. My dear learner, you must have listened about a proverb which is like, ghat ghat par pani badle, kos kos par bani, which means we get a new language a mile away in India if we move on. Therefore, my dear learner, our today's topic is a picture of India's linguistic diversity. There are a few questions which I want to ask from you before moving towards our topic, and the proposed flow is on screen. We are going to expose through a lesson guide that how I would move in the lesson, the expectations in terms of learning objectives or outcome. We will do discussion on linguistic diversities in India. We will also expose to multilingualism and related issues. We will do a recapitulation at the end of the lecture, and I'll also give a take-home task to you. This is a lesson guide. While I am presenting the topic, I will explain it with the help of examples. You need to attend to my voice and the slides as well. You will find important words, sentences have been highlighted for retention. I have also put a summary at the end for retention. I have put some questions, exercises in between and at the end of my presentation. You must attempt to answer those questions or perform those exercises after going through the video lesson. My dear learners, coming back on the linguistic diversity, I want to ask a few questions from you. How many languages are spoken world over? Can you tell me? And how many languages we, the Indians, speak? What is the proportion of the languages spoken in India to the language spoken in the world? My dear learners, here are the answers on screen. World over, there are approximately 5,000 languages which have been spoken by the people living in on the earth. There are 1600 languages approximately which are there in India itself, and therefore the proportion of language spoken by Indian over the language spoken in world comes around 1/3. When we are having such a linguistic diversity, it just the things which I presented right now in front of you just show a micro perspective of the languages in India or the linguistic diversity in India. The micro perspective, when expand over the macro perspective, we are having a 6,661 raw return of mother tongue which have been identified in the census 2001 data, which is also cited in census 2011 data. And this identification is done on the basis of identification of the mother tongue. My dear learner, you must know what is a mother tongue. A mother tongue is a tongue spoken by the mother of a child. And if the mother is absent in the family, it is the language of the family. Therefore, there have been 6,661 mother tongue which have been identified by census 2001. And when we get them affiliated with the actual languages and dialects, the number reduced to 1,635, which are also called as rationalized mother tongue as per census data 2001. Besides these 1,635 rationalized mother tongues, there are also unclassified or other mother tongues. Their number is 1,957. My dear learner, these 1,635 rationalized mother tongues further classified or categorized in 122 languages belonging to five language families. This language family categorization is as per the world data. First family, we are having Indo-European family. In Indo-European family, we are having three subgroups of language. First subgroup of language is Indo-Aryan group of language, in which we are having 21 languages out of 122 classified languages. Then the second subfamily is Iranian family, in which we are having two languages. Then the third subfamily is Germanic family, in which we are having one language. The second family of the Indian language is Dravidian family, in which we are having 17 languages. Then we are having Austroasiatic language family, in which we are having 14 Indian languages classified. We are having the fourth language family as Tibeto-Burmese language family, in which we are having the highest number of languages identified, which comes around 66. And then there is a fifth language family, which is called Semito-Hamitic language family, in which we are having one language classified. And the total of these classified language comes around 122. It is as per census data 2001. Here is a picture of which language is under which group. The first language family is of Indo-European family, under which we are having first subgroup as Indo-Aryan subgroup, and in that subgroup we are having Assami, Bengali, Bhili or Bhilodi, Vishnupuriya, Dogri, Gujarati, Halabi, Hindi, Kashmiri, Kandeshi, Konkani, Landa, Maithili, Marathi, Nepali, Odia, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Sina, Sindhi and Urdu. The second subgroup in the same family, that is Indo-European family, is Iranian, and in that subgroup, subfamily, we are having two languages, which are Afghani or Kabuli or Pashto, and the second language is Persian, which has been used in India. In the third language subgroup, we are having Germanic subgroup, and in which we are having one language, which is English. As far as the second family of language is considered, we are having Dravidian family, and in Dravidian family, we are having Kurgi or Kadagu, Gondi as second language, third language is Latapu, Kannada, Kondi or Kond, Kesan, Kolami, Konda, Koya, Kui, Kurk or Orion, Malayalam, Malato, Parji, Tamil, Telugu and Tulu languages as 17 languages. The third family is termed as Austroasiatic family, in which we are having 14 language, which are Bhumji, Gadaba, Ho, Juang, Kharia, Khasi, Koda or Kora, Koraku, Korava, Munda, Mundari, Nikobarse, Santhali, and Swara or Sora language. The third language family, in which we are having grossly 66 Indian languages, is Tibeto-Burmese family, in which we are having Adi, Enal, Angami, O, Balati, Bhotia, Bodo, Chakseng, Chakru or Choki, Chang, Deori, Demisa, Gangte, Garo, Halam, Hamar, Kabui, Karbi, Khejha, Kemuguna, Kinnori, Koch, Kom, Konyak, Kuki, Ladakhi, Laholi, Lakhar, Lalang, Lepcha, ल्यान मई, लिंबू, लोथा, लुशियाई और मीज़ो, मणिपुरी, माराम, मारिंग, मिरी और मिशिंग, मिशमी, मोग, मोनप्पा, निसी और दफला, नोक्ते, पायता, पावी, पोम, पोचुरु, रभा, राय, रेंगमा, संगतम, सेमा, शेरपा, सिमते, तमांग, तंगकुल, तंगजा, थाडो, तिब्बतन, त्रिपुरी, वैफी, वांचो, यिमचोंगरे, ज़ेलांग, ज़ेमी एंड ज़ो. एंड द फिफ्थ फैमिली इन विच देर इज़ ओनली वन लैंग्वेज इज़ सेमिटो हेमेटिक फैमिली इन विच वी आर हैविंग अरेबिक और अरबी एज अ लैंग्वेज ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ लुक एट द पावर पॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन इन विच आई हैव शोन अ मैप ऑफ इंडिया विच शोज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस इन इंडिया. द कलर्ड एरिया, ग्रीन कलर्ड एरिया शोज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इंडो यूरोपियन लैंग्वेजेस, इंडो यूरोपियन ग्रुप ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस. द रेड एरिया शोज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द्रविडियन लैंग्वेजेस. द येलो एरिया शोज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ तिब्बतो बर्मन लैंग्वेजेस. द blue area shows the distribution of Munda language. The light blue area shows the Mon or Khmer language, and the purple area shows the Borshakhi language. We can easily see over the map that the most of the area in Indian geography is covered, or the distribution of the Indo-European languages is the largest. And afterwards comes the Dravidian languages. Here are the rough statistics which shows the distribution of different family of languages in India. We are having 70% of the area distributed to Indo-European families, which means that 70% of Indian population speaks the language which belongs to Indo-European families, and into that also the subgroup of Indo-Aryan families. The 20% of language users belong to Dravidian family, and others counts at 10%. And here is a graphical representation of the distribution as per the language users. Now a question comes, if the language are distributed and Indo-Aryan family is dominating, are we, the people of India, speaking only one language? I think the answer is no. Most of us in India speaks many languages. In fact, we all are multilingual. Therefore, it is required to look at India as one linguistic area, which means as an area where people speaks more than one language, as an area where people are living together with different languages from thousand and thousand of years, and therefore our languages are also living together from thousand of years. Therefore, these languages, after getting living together from thousands of years, are intermingling with each other, getting associated with each other, and therefore they have borrowed from each other, which gives birth to structural similarities. There are some structural similarities which have been exhibited on screen. For example, all of Indian languages have eco words. These eco words are the words which repeat the same word or the same tone. Like in Hindi, we speak khana bana, and in Oriya, we speak bhago phago. The second word generally doesn't have any meaning. These kind of words are called eco words. The second structural similarity is reduplicated words. These reduplicated words could be noun, adjectives, or adverbs repeated to create a new word. For example, in Hindi, we call ghar ghar. In Telugu, we call dhore dhore. The second word here, if associated with the first word, though it's same, but it connotes a different process. For example, as a child, we must, all of us have played a game which is called ghar ghar, which is essentially different from the meaning of the word called ghar. It's a game. Ghar ghar is the name of the game. Therefore, when we associate a noun or adjective or adverb repeated to create, it creates a new word. In all the Indian languages, it happens in all the Indian languages. Then there is another structural similarity which is called postposition, in which prepositional words are placed always after noun. For example, in Hindi, we write Ram ka, and in Tamil, we write Ramod. In Hindi, we speak Ram ka, and in Tamil, we speak Ramod. But in English, we speak the thing is belonging to Ram. It means position or prepositional word comes before the noun in English, but in Hindi and in other Indian languages, the prepositional word always comes after the noun only. You must be surprising, I have just hinted the characteristic of multilingualism of each and every citizen of India. We, the people of India, all of us speak more than two languages, in fact. Therefore, for us, the reality is multilingualism, and the reality is not monolingualism like in other societies. There are pressures from external forces when we talk of other societies, but in India, there are internal forces in terms of linguistic diversities when we talk about or when we give example of India, because we are having multiple languages living together and we all are multilingual. And the evidences of being multilingual is the Indian Constitution, which is considered as the supreme law, and its 8th schedule, which specifically speak about the position of different languages in India, and it specifies 22 Indian languages or recognizes 22 Indian languages as the scheduled languages of India, in which different states functions, in which different states perform their official works. Then our artistic creation are another evidence of being multilingual in India. Our media, movies, radio, newspaper. Have you ever listened to the announcement or the comparing of radio jockeys nowadays? Is it in one language? No. It is in multiple language. They use English, they use Hindi, sometimes Punjabi. They mix all the languages. So our artistic creation, media, movies, radio, newspaper are another example or another evidence of ours being multilingual. Multilingualism has a close relationship with language proficiency, scholastic achievements, and cognitive flexibility. The researchers who are working in the field of multilingualism found that the people who speak more than one language or use more than one language have better understanding, better expression, and better cognitive flexibility because they are getting acclimatized with different kind of stimuli coming in different modes easily. Therefore, there could be a close relationship as found out by the researchers in multilingualism in language proficiency, scholastic achievement, and cognitive flexibilities. Likewise, the people who are multilingual are also able to grasp or learn a new language quickly. But My dear learners, I just want to attract your attention or grab your attention towards a point which could be said like, due to the continuous interaction of different languages, external pressures and the things which are beyond the control of a nation, there is a relationship in the language or amongst the language which is coming up in terms of some dominating languages or some dominated languages, because of which there are many languages which are dying, for example, tribal languages. And India has witnessed many language conflicts in history, for example, in Goa, Konkani versus Marathi conflict is there, and in all of India, we are having Hindi versus English conflict, Hindi or English versus other language conflict. Everyone amongst us is of concern that the language which is our mother tongue or the language which we speak should be considered as the language of the masses. And because of this demand, because of this concern, we are witnessing many language conflict, and the Indian history has witnessed the strongest and the ugliest language conflict in 1949, when there was an anti-Hindi movement in the southern states which speak Dravidian languages. Therefore, my dear learners, as a teacher at elementary level, you need to understand that our uniqueness or the uniqueness of our country is in its rich linguistic and cultural heritage. Therefore, we are required to understand that these multiple languages or different languages should coexist with each other, and therefore, you need to understand that as a teacher, your role is becoming more and more complex, because you are going to get diversities in your classroom, and these diversities need to be cherished, as these diversities would help in keeping the Indian identity of a diversely glorified cultural and linguistic heritage as intact and unique. Therefore, my dear learners, you need to work hard as a teacher on the things which cherish the multilingualism in your student and which gives a glimpse of all the languages, at least which gives the glimpse of all the languages to your learners, so that they can functionally interact with each other and keep the Indian unity in diversity intact. To sum up, in this lesson, we have discussed about multilinguality as an essential character of Indian culture. We have also discussed about rich linguistic diversity of India. We have discussed the five families in which 122 prominent Indian languages are placed as per Indian Census 2001. We have also discussed about how the languages are distributed in India as per the language user. We have also discussed about the need for building positive attitude and culture to maintain and cherish India's linguistic diversity. My dear learners, our job is not finished. After going through this lesson, I expect you to develop a linguistic profile of the area you are living in, and also categorize the languages which the people in your vicinity are using in the different language family. With this, I thank you all for joining this video lesson. After that, we will be meeting in other video lesson, which is on what is the place of different languages in Indian Constitution. Thank you very much.